Much time and effort are spent fabricating wax patterns used in the lost wax technique, by which dental castings are made. The method requires a properly prepared tooth, an accurate impression and stone cast. A wax pattern, invested in stone, is subsequently vaporized in an electric oven. The resulting hollow mold is then filled with molten casting alloy. The resulting casting is retrieved, polished, and delivered to the patient. As the solidifying metal cools to room temperature, it shrinks. The dimensional accuracy of the casting is achieved by balancing this shrinkage against precisely controlled expansion of the mold. Wax is used for the pattern, because it is easily manipulated into the correct shape. Every defect in the wax will appear in the casting, therefore meticulous attention to detail is required to achieve a satisfactory result. Errors are more easily corrected in wax than in the resulting casting.
Crown contour is under the control of the dentist. The restoration should be anatomically accurate and well-fitting. The restoration should be cleansable by the patient, and should not unduly contribute to periodontal disease. A basic understanding of tooth morphology is required. Often, one may use existing preoperative casts of the tooth or the contralateral tooth to guide the waxing. Correct embrasure form is necessary for gingival health and clansability. Below the contact, the proximal surfaces tend to be concave or flat. Note the triangular shape of the posterior embrasure space. It is critical to gingival health to maintain space for the dental papilla.
Posterior mandibular contacts as seen from the facial view. Posterior mandibular proximal contacts are located in the occlusal one-third. Deficient or concave contacts are a source of food impaction with pain and aggravation. Excessively broad or rough contacts discourage flossing and increase the risk of plaque formation. Floss should not fray or tear when placed or removed from the proximal space.
Location of mandibular proximal contacts, as seen from the occlusal view. Note how the location progressively changes. The slide illustrates embrasure symmetry. Buccal lingual embrasures are symmetrical about a line drawn through the contact.
The slide illustrates embrasure symmetry. Occlusal gingival embrasures are symmetrical about a line drawn through the contact. Establishing the correct embrasure form is essential for effective hygienic procedures. The restoration should be contoured to the ideal tooth contour. The height of contour on the buccal of 30 is in the gingival one-third. On the lingual, it is in the middle one-third. The pattern is examined from a two-dimensional perspective, from a variety of angles against a contrasting background. Teeth are rarely greater than 1 mm wider at the height of contour than at the CEJ. The emergence profile is the contour of the tooth, as it relates to adjacent tissues. The emergence profile of the tooth in the gingival one-third is slightly concave or flat. Avoid making the restoration excessively convex. Inadequate tooth preparation is a major cause of bulky crowns. To ensure that proximal contacts are not deficient, a small amount of stone is scraped from the adjacent tooth prior to waxing.
The dye is separated from the stone master cast. The dye is stable on the cast and will fit on and off predictably. The margin finish line on the dye is marked in red wax pencil. This color will provide contrast with the blue wax. Traces of graphite from a regular pencil may cause incomplete casting, because it is in anti-flux. The dye is thoroughly saturated with dye lube. This process may be repeated periodically.
The shank of the waxing instrument is warmed. In this manner, the working tip stays clean and the flow of wax is improved. Wax is placed on the dye with a wax spatula. The initial increments of wax should be hot enough to melt the prior layer of wax to prevent creases from forming.
A layer of wax is placed on the die. The internal surface of the pattern is established. A large instrument such as the number 7 wax spatula performs this more efficiently. Wax is added incrementally. The wax must be hot enough to be thoroughly incorporated by remelting the previous increment.
Using a warm blunt instrument, burnish or carve wax very carefully to the margin. Allow to cool. Sufficient bulk of wax must exist to prevent breakage. Then carefully remove the pattern from the die. Ability to remove before investing serious time is preferable. Inspect the internal surface of the pattern. There should be no creases or wrinkles in the wax. Only a perfect adaptation to the die surface.
Once the internal surface is established, proximal surfaces are added. Contacts with adjacent teeth are established at the appropriate position. Cooler wax may be used subsequent to the establishment of the internal surface.
Both proximal contacts are added. The gingival contour of the wax should be consistent with tooth surface immediately below the margin, that is, the emergence profile.
Refine axial contour as needed. Axial contour is shaped to follow the contour of adjacent teeth. Teeth are rarely more than 1 mm wider at the height of contour and at the CEJ.
Begin to develop the occlusal anatomy. The wax is warmed and the casts are closed together. Areas of occlusion will be indented on the wax. Continue to refine anatomy and establish occlusal contacts. Sufficient horizontal overlap should exist to prevent cheek-tongue biting. In the posterior area, avoid edge-to-edge occlusion. Continue to refine anatomy and establish occlusal contacts. Avoid broad contacts. Discrete points are preferred. Avoid contacts on inclines. Flat surfaces are preferred.
Tooth-to-tooth. Cusp fossa. Occlusion. Mandibular functional cusps contact opposing fossa.
Tooth. 2. Two-tooth occlusion. The buccal cusp of the mandibular premolars and the mesial buccal cusp of mandibular molars contact the embrasures of the maxillary teeth.
Wax has a relatively high coefficient of thermal expansion and changes dimensions subject to ambient conditions. Because of this, the margins are relaxed prior to investing and carefully inspected for areas where wax runs over the margin. Note the arrow. Remove the pattern, replace die lube, reseat the pattern, and remelt the margins, being sure to blend the wax. Add more wax, carve to the margin. Carefully examine for overwaxing. The final waxing is smoothed with cotton pellets and die lube. Contact placement, embrasure form, axial height of contour, marginal ridge height, and occlusion are verified.
Embrasure space is evaluated, as well as the form of the interproximal axial walls and location of contact. The waxed crown ready to cast. Excellent marginal adaptation reduces dissolution of cement and improves the patient ability to clean. Excellent wax preparation minimizes finishing and polishing of the casting. Magnification is helpful to verify